Hi, in the previous tutorial, we have learned how to display the week number with date range by using a super simple method in the Looker Studio by just changing the data type from date into ISO year week. This is super useful and simple, but you may have noticed that the label is way too long and it is taking up so much space in our dashboard. So for more efficient use of our space, I would like to introduce you to this new way and customized way of labeling the weeks along with the date ranges. So by the end of this tutorial, this is the format that you're going to get. It starts with a week number where we'll have the capital letter W to replace the full name of week. And we'll have the date range behind. We'll only include the day and month and we'll remove the year part from the date. So then the label is shorter and we can save up more space without losing the information. Once you understand fully how this method works, you can easily customize it to cater for other type of formatting that you will need for your dashboard. Just a reminder here that you can refer back to chapter 2 to learn how to format the date time. Otherwise, if you have any further questions, feel free to post it in our community page so I will look into it for you. And yeah, that's all. Let's get started. I'm going to just copy the table here so then I can refer to it later. And now I'm going to add a new field. We're going to start by taking the first day of the week. And we're going to start Monday. And here we're going to just use the formula date time trunc followed by date field. And for the part, we're going to use ISO week. If we refer to the formula guide here, if we truncate to ISO week, it will start on Monday, which means this will give us the first day of the week and it will always be on Monday. So with that in mind, click save and finish. Then we can just drag and drop this first day of the week in the dimension. So we can clearly see that this has been computed correctly because based on this default format, the first week started with 25th December, which is aligned with this calculated field. Also for this entire tutorial, the week will always start from Monday. So if you want it to start on Sunday, feel free to change the ISO year week part in the formula to week. Next, we're going to get last day of the week. To get the last day of the week, it's very simple. We can use the previous strategy that we have, which is by adding 1 week and minus 1 day from the current first day of the week. So with that, I would like to add a new field and just call it as last day of the week. And we can go by datetime trunc date ISO week, which is the previous formula that we used to get the first day of the week. And then we're going to add 1 week to it. Click save, finish. This is not yet the last day of the week, it's just for us to see the values before we proceed to minus 1 day. So you can see I can get the first day of next week. So I'm going to minus 1 day from here. Use the datetime sub function and comma interval 1 day. So this will minus 1 day. So you can see that I can now get the first day of the week and last day of the week from here. See? 31st December, 31st December. Next, we want to get the week number. So to get the week number is pretty easy as well. So we can create a new field here. So now you can use the format date time to get week number from the date. So you can use percentage capital letter V to get the week number. Click save and finish. So you can see I can just drag and drop this here. Other than this formula, you can also use week followed by date. This will also give you the same output, but I'll just use this one because I want to make the week shorter by using the abbreviation. So once we get these three information, we can now combine them so that we can have a custom week label. So now we can click add the field and let's say custom week labels. And here we can just write concat. We can start with the week number, starts Monday, and then followed by the date range, which I'm going to start with a parenthesis. And let me just do for the closing as well, comma. And in between them, we will want to enter the first day of the week. And we want to enter a range, which is a hyphen. Then last day of the week. Then click save and finish. So custom week label is here. We can drag and drop it to the table. I can see that this has combined the timestamp. So we want to just make this into a date instead of a timestamp. So I can actually go first day of the week to just put a date formula here. So then we can make it date and remove the timestamp behind. Same for the last day of the week. Just add a date formula and wrap the entire formula earlier. Click update and finish. Now we should see just dates in these two fields. So this is what we want. And you can see right away that this custom week label has been updated as well. Once we have updated these two, because we have pulled them in by using the calculator field, so it kind of automatically updated. Now I want to add a W in front of the week number here, so that is more user friendly in that way. So I can go to the custom week label, and in front of this field, I can add a comma and add the word W and click update. So now I should have W52 here. That's what I want. As for the date here, if let's say you want to keep it shorter and not taking so much space, you can always do that. So we can go to the week labels here, and for this first day of the week, we can just add a formula format date time, add the comma here, and here you can put in this string %m%d. So between them, I want to put a slash, or you can put a hyphen, or you can put a dot. It really doesn't matter. For me, I will just put slash here because I already have a hyphen here. And for last day of the week, I'm going to just do it here. So you can just wrap the last week of the year inside the formula format date time, and you'll have to indicate this format string. And with that, you can click update and finish. So now you can see the custom week label here. That's all for today. If you have any questions, feel free to post it in our community page and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.